Bhageeratha. In the dynasty of Ambarisha, one Bahuka was born. And when he was ruling the kingdom, enemies attacked him and he was defeated. Leaving the kingdom, he ran to the forest with his several wives, lived and died there. He had no issues. But when he died, one of the wives was pregnant. The other wives became jealous of her. They secretly administered poison to her so that she may also not beget a child. But in spite of the poison, she gave birth to a son, and he was called Sagrad, one with poison. He became the emperor and performed several horse sacrifices. In the 100th sacrifice, Indra stole the horse and hid it. Sagara sent his 60,000 sons to search for the horse and bring it to the Yajnashala. They searched for it all over the earth but could not find it. Without abandoning the search, they dug the earth to the subterranean region and at last found the horse behind the sage Bhagavan Kapila, who was there performing tapas since the time he left his father's place, Kardamashramam. The sons of Sagara presumed that the sage must have stolen the horse and so wanted to punish him. By the very act of their vicious thought, they were all burned to ashes. As the sons never returned, Sagara sent his grandson Amshuman to fetch the horse. Amshuman searched all over the land and then he followed the path dug out by his fathers to the subterranean region and found the horse behind the sage Kapila. Being born with very noble qualities, he was very cautious. He saluted the sage and began to praise him. He did not express the purpose of his visit. He simply waited for the pleasure of the sage. The sage was much pleased with his noble conduct. Even without being requested, the sage allowed him to take the horse. Amshuman again saluted the sage and took the horse, and Sagara completed his sacrifice. As directed by sage Kapila, Amshuman wanted to wash off the ashes of his fathers in the subterranean region with the celestial waters of Ganga so that they may attain salvation. He started to perform tapas but died. His son Dilip also died in the same attempt. Dilip's son Bhageeratha continued the tapas for the sake of getting the celestial Ganga and he was successful. Goddess Ganga was pleased with him and promised to flow down to the earth as directed by him. But her force of descent from the heavens would be so great that it might wash off the earth. So she advised Bhageeratha to be prepared with necessary help. Bhageeratha prayed to Lord Shiva for helping him in this respect and he also agreed. When Ganga was falling from the heavens, Lord Shiva received her in his locks of hair on the head and blocked her fierce flow. Then Lord Shiva went into his usual meditation. No water came out. Bhageeratha again prayed to Lord Shiva to graciously let out some water. Then from the head of Lord Shiva, the Ganga flowed over the Himalayas and down the plains. Bhageeratha showed the way for the river through the plains of the country, making it extensively fertile, and finally he led it to the subterranean regions where the ashes of his forefathers were lying. He had the ashes washed off in the Ganga, and thus the 60,000 sons of Sagara were absolved of all their sins and they reached heaven. The determined effort of Bhageeratha stands foremost in the history as a superhuman effort, and the river is named after him as Bhageerathi. The celestial Ganga is the Vedic knowledge, Jnana Ganga. Shiva is the Sadguru, who alone is capable of receiving it, and he delivers it to the disciples in easy lessons so that the disciples may understand it well.